My name's Reed Shelton with Delmarvanow.com, and I'm here with First Lieutenant Skip Lee of the Ocean City Beach Patrol, and he's going to demonstrate on me today what a sand hole extrication looks like.
That's why we're here.
Thank you very much, sir. First of all, can you just sort of explain what's about to happen here?
Sure. So there's heightened awareness about the dangers of deep holes in Ocean City, and so what we're going to do is we're going to replicate what a typical day at the beach might include, which may be a bucket or a sand shovel you buy from one of the local sundry shops, and just kids or even a family member digging a hole thinking it's all fun and games. Unfortunately, it does not always end up that way.
You know, now this hole, although a little deep, it looks relatively innocent.
In fact, it looks inviting.
It looks fun.
I'm from the Baltimore area, and in my backyard, as my kids were young, they dug holes all the time. That was part of the joy of living where we live. But the dirt and the root structure and all that stuff back at home is significantly different than it is on a sandy beach.
And what's the end result of that? Is this what makes it dangerous?
What happens, Reed, is that the sand becomes very uncompact very quickly. And it all has to do with sunlight, the sand drying rapidly. 6 to 8 inches below the surface of this sand is nice and cool sand. So if you were running across the beach and your feet were burning, if you quickly stop and dig down, you're gonna cool off. That's because the sand down there is cool. It also has a higher content of water. When it's exposed to the sun, which is what we've done with this hole here, it begins to dry out rapidly, and all of that adhesion factor that used to exist no longer is there, and that's why the sand becomes so unstable.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yep.
So go ahead and move forward your feet a little bit further, and sit back. Yep. It's a little bit lower if you can. You're already feeling a little woozy, aren't you?
It's already a little claustrophobic. Okay. I'm not gonna lie.
So right now you're in a controlled environment. You're a family member. You've been digging with your friends or your family member all day, and it's for all intent and purposes, it's fine right now.
Yep.
Okay. For the demonstration, though, I want you to keep your hands up, because what we're going to do is I'm going to make a heel strike there and on the same side, and what's going to happen is the sides of the walls are going to come in on you.
Okay.
So that's what's going to happen. Ready, Butch?
Yeah, absolutely. Hands up.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, Reed, so just relax. Mm-hmm. And I know you said it was awful, but I want to try to put things in perspective right now. When we were on our other shot, I mentioned about us coming onto the scene and telling people about, you know, it's important that you don't dig holes. If you do dig a hole, make it knee deep to the smallest person in the area.
Right.
Think about you. You're probably 5'10". I'm 5'8". I've been digging a hole. My little 3-year-old crawls into that hole. Feel the pressure you're under right now.
I feel it.
That child, first of all, is not going to have the wherewithal to know what to do. And the weight of the sand is going to be so compounded. It actually makes me upset right now just even thinking about it.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about, how do you feel right now?
There is a lot of pressure. I can feel my pulse in my legs, actually. There is a ton of pressure on my legs right now. This is, I don't want my audience to think I'm hamming it up, but this is genuinely uncomfortable. My legs are under a lot of weight. My hips and my waist in general are under a ton of weight. It feels really claustrophobic.
Before we went on air, you talked about possibly getting yourself out, wiggling yourself. I want you to go ahead and try.
No.
So we're in a 3.5-foot
There's
foot
no
hole.
Way it's happening.
Right.
Absolutely not.
Okay. So if we're pretending you're submerged, your head's underwater, under the sand, we've got somebody who says, hey, somebody's down in that hole. And so our extrication process is considered a series of concentric rings. There are going to be three of us that respond to the emergency, literally right up front with you, and all we're using is our hands. Mm-hmm. If we can't use a shovel, we can't use a bucket, we can't use a tractor, because if we hit your skin, we're going to inflict more injury, right?
Right.
So we're coming in, and the first row of responders are pulling sand away from the body, or digging down. We're looking for evidence of where the body is. The second set of responders are subsequent responders. They're gonna be back near my hips. They're gonna be pulling the material that I pull out. They're gonna be pulling that back, because if we just build a pile here, what's going to happen?
It's going to slide right back.
It's going to slide right back in.
So the idea is to make a wide.
That's exactly right. And try to go at a 45 degree angle. So you'll see as we respond, the response is going to be out and up and back to my hips. And we're going to try to pull this way. And the people behind are pulling that material and moving it as way as far back from you as possible.
Okay.
Ready?
Very much so.
Ready, guys? Go.
Okay, so that is all done. I have to honestly admit that I'm really happy that's over. It was incredibly uncomfortable. You asked me how I felt when the first sort of cave-in came from both sides, and the immediate answer is it panicked.
Sure.
You know, my heart rate went up, and it was a little frightening.
And that was with you knowing what was about to come, but it's very difficult to describe and replicate that with words.
Yeah, exactly. Even surrounded by beach patrol, the weight was immediate and very heavy, and incredibly uncomfortable. I'm still trying to calm myself down.
No,
I'm not going to lie about it.
I get it.
So I guess ultimately, you know, what sort of message do you have to parents that are letting their children dig out here on the sand? People who have the idea of coming here after hours and digging. What do you have to say about this?
Well, you mentioned the after hours piece. But let me talk about the during the day. The number one most effective way of making sure a person is safe is to just go talk to the lifeguard. You know, we have got a list of prohibited and restricted activities, one of which is deep hole digging. The guards can give you anecdotal experiences of their own, as well as some firsthand suggestions on how to be safe. But with respect to hole digging, the biggest takeaway from this is to understand that the beach sand is different than the sand from home.
Sure.
That it's the dynamics of it, the contour of it, the way it works is different than what we're typically used to when we go out to the backyard and dig a fort.
The stability of it is so much different. As soon as you and Captain Arbin stomped down on either side, there was an immediate cave in and a lot of weight. I really
Indeed.
Can't understate just how heavy that was.
Now,
right
earlier
off the
we
bat.
Were talking about what's the possible square footage weight. I don't recall what you said.
About 100 to 120 pounds per cubic foot is what I understand it to be.
So
which
we're talking
is
about this much, and you
a
probably
lot.
Had
yeah,
25 to 30 times that.
Felt about like that.
Easily.
Yeah, easily. And as for people that have the idea to come out here after hours and dig.
It makes it quinge just even thinking about it. I cannot think of any reason why that would be the goal of somebody after the guards go off at 5:30 to come out and dig a hole. Just, you know, go wide, stay shallow. If you're into digging, you know, make a long trough that's 12 inches deep, but please don't go down.
Knee height to the smallest person in the party is what I understand it to be.
Yes, sir. That's what we enforce.
Okay, Lieutenant. Thank you so much for
My
your time.
Pleasure.
Thank you very much.
Yep.